done bad things. My soul is damned. Satan's creatures will take me should I stray from the path of peace.
Solomon, the devil was here.
Solomon! Here's your last chance. Where is the girl? There is evil walking this earth, and I will hunt it down and send it burning back to hell.
Every step you took, every pain you suffered, led you to here.
I am not yet ready for hell.
Come on.
There are many paths to redemption. Not all of them peaceful.
Hi, my name is James Purefoy. I'm an actor, and I'm here to talk about A Night Less Ordinary.
The incredible danger and beauty of theatre work is you can't say cut, you can't go again. It's a high wire act. You have to deal with what's happening in that moment, at that moment, every single night. And there have been times, certainly in my career on stage, when things have gone disastrously wrong, when I would have given good money to watch those actors deal with those things and remain in character. It's an incredibly exciting art form. Some of the jewels in the theatre crown are often not to be found in Shaftesbury Avenue at all, but are found in the smaller theatres in and around every major city. I went to see Lulu in Peter Pan at the London Palladium when I was about 8, and I became terribly sexually confused by her because Lulu was really hot. I mean, like, drop-dead sexy hot, and yet she was a guy. And I didn't kind of understand this. In fact, I didn't find out that it was a chick until I came out afterwards. I went, I understand. Why would Peter Pan have boobs, Mum? Because it was a woman. I had no idea. But they did this extraordinary thing in there, which was they had this disco ball up in the gods, and they shone a light on it. And when Peter Pan said, do you believe in fairies? Do you believe in fairies? Suddenly the light came on and the whole theater was full of fairies. And as an 8-year-old boy, I may be slightly backward, but I did really believe that the whole theater was full of fairies. And I still have, my pulse still quickens when I go to see Peter Pan. And when the crocodile comes on, or when the Captain Hook comes on, I still get, to this day, a slight tremor of nerves. I do take dates to theatre, but theatre is such a big part of my life. You know, I mean, I try and go to the theatre probably once or twice a week anyway, if I can, if I'm not working. Generally speaking, you know, the date's got to fit in with the theatre rather than the theatre fit in with the dates with me. If they don't like theatre, then they're not really going to be my kind of girl. We did Death of a Salesman once. I did it with Jude Law and Ken Stott at West Yorkshire Playhouse. And often there was this moment where the play would finish and there'd be a very long pause and the lights would come up and we'd sort of be waiting for them to applaud, and then the applause would start. And that pause wasn't because they didn't like it, it was because they loved it. And they were so moved by what they'd seen that they couldn't bring themselves to finish the evening. They were trying to prolong the evening just a few more seconds. And that is just, it's just like a little bit of gold dust to an actor. It's incredibly exciting when that happens because it means you've genuinely had an effect on someone. And that's really all you're there to do is have an effect on someone, a profound effect. And if it works, it works blindingly well. We're having very early discussions at the moment about doing a production of Macbeth at the end of this year or the beginning of next year. I don't think it's going to be in a theatre though. I think it's going to be in site-specific spaces. So it might be in a warehouse, or it might be on tour in a disused swimming pool in one of the towns outside London, or it might be in railway arches. It'll be a promenade performance. It'll be hyper sexy and very violent and terrifying. And that's what it should be, Macbeth, because it's got all those things in it. And if you get all those ingredients right, you definitely do get A Night Less Ordinary. If you're wondering about what to do with your evening this evening and you kind of fancy having a go at a bit of theatre but you've never been before, don't be alarmed, don't be scared.
go to the A Night Less Ordinary website or go to your local listings trying to find out a participating theatre, you can get into one of these theatres for free. Like nothing. Really, nothing. Just, you know, just for a price of a drink at the bar at the interval. And it may just, and I mean may, just change your life.